Some voice acting has been completed and a new trailer on the horizon. Today we are going to be discussing the big hard-hitting questions that everyone has been asking since December 2021's pre-animated Bleach trailer. And that is what we're going to be discussing today. So if you haven't heard the recent news as of recently, a few days ago there has been a post from the man, the myth, the legend himself, Taikubo, about the voice acting of the Bleach anime, starting off with episode 1. And we have an episode 1 title card of what the episode is going to be called, as well as some information about the dubbing of the episode as well. And when I say dubbing, I mean the Japanese dub, because that's what you would call it. I know a lot of us in the West are known as dubbing as, you know, dubbing over the Japanese voice actors, but no, this is about the specific Japanese voice lines that have been recorded as of recently. And we're going to be talking about why that is really important. So let's discuss about what has been said first and foremost. Now, if you're a member of the fan club outside, you would have known that Kubo a few days ago had released a picture of the Thousand Year Blood War arc script, as well as the title card of that episode being episode 1, just to clarify on that, because we'll be discussing a bit more on that in a moment. But his comment goes as follows. The first recording session is over. It was so much fun. Of course, Ichigo and the others were great, but everyone was great, even those in lesser roles. I'm sure that when you see the full film, you'll be like, they had such a good voice. And that's great, because episode 1 has been recorded for its voice lines. Does that mean the anime episode 1 has been completed? No, and we're going to discuss a little bit further elaborating on that. Now, I do just want to touch up a little bit on the episode card being The Blood Warfare, which is the first volume name of volume 55 with Uobach on the cover. Again, to me, nothing too special. I'm glad that they are using Kubo's titles for certain episodes. So again, this makes a lot of sense to name it this. And again, I imagine the next one will be, you know, 4 or 5 chapters later, they'll use a title card for that. Or they could generally probably keep to the volume cover names. I don't quite know. But again, it was really cool to see, and to see the new Bleach logo and the script in hand as well. It's kind of nice to see a little bit of background of what those look like as well, for those who aren't really fully aware of what like the behind the scenes voice line scripts look like. So very excited to see how that first episode is going to be dropping. Because if you also don't know, unlike in the Western world, is that most actors will do their lines individually, and then like the next person will come in and they'll do their lines in individually, and then they'll usually mix those tracks in together. But for the Japanese, they usually do the voice lines as a group or together. And I think like they've kind of nailed that down to a T, because it's more efficient. Even the people with the lesser roles, such as like the Shinigamis in the Soul Society and whatnot, you know, the fact that they've got castings for those or extras for those, and they've done a good job as well. I'm glad that Kubo fully enjoyed the day and is fully happy with the result that turned up. And it's understandable, people are excited about the first episode being dubbed, because it gives us an idea of where we are in the anime and what we can expect, and when we can kind of see how the production is going, especially of when we're going to be getting that next trailer, which I think personally, in my view, is not going to be this month. I don't think it's going to be July, but I do believe it might be in August. Now, I will kind of elaborate onto why. Because the big question is episode 1 completed? And the answer to that question is, could be. Or it could not be. But I'm more so on the fence of it could not be, because even though voice acting is done, there is still a lot of elements that go into it, such as like special effects and compositing, for example. And I think the perfect example for this as well is from the latest Dragon Ball Super Heroes movie, where we see a Gohan picture from the voice acting stage, from where the voice actors come and did their voice acting, obviously, for Gohan, especially in this image anyway. And you can see the contrast difference between this draft version and the version of the finalized version in the TV spots or the TV PVs. So I would imagine that Bleach is in a stage at the moment, or especially episode 1 in this case, and I imagine a few other episodes as well, is where they are completed in terms of like the storyboarding and the animation and the drafting, for example, and you have the bare bones of which the voice actors can essentially voice over those lines and make those lines, so the sound mixing can be done simultaneously to the effects and compositing and the color corrections and the CGI. Now, I want to make sure that just because I said CGI doesn't mean that the Bleach anime is going to be CGI at all, because it is not, and I want to put that to bed. But for example, in the Dragon Ball movie, for example, you can see like a green screen on the books, for example, and it's little things like that where like the CGI is used for that kind of aspect, where they put overlays onto certain like backgrounds, etc., like maybe the background of like the sky or the backgrounds of the Soul Society buildings, for example. Like those could be not even touched upon or detailed yet. It's just the bare bones of the characters, not even shell shaded like that, or having their line filters added on, etc. So, you know, that's where we are. I would say we're at the end. We're in the post-editing stage of the animation so far, especially for episode one. And I imagine a few other episodes as well. And I imagine once a few lines have been recorded for other episodes as well, and some compositing and editing's been done for those, that's when they can start like kind of editing and cutting out clips to make a compelling PV for the TVs. So I think that's what were on people's minds a lot, is when a PV is going to be happening. And I do but generally believe it's going to be end of July, in the middle of August, because again, now that Dragon Ball Super is coming out, it's coming out very soon. And even with like in the past of other animes coming out, they usually have like a 3 month like marketing campaign where they just bash out a lot of like teasers and whatnot. And we're getting to that point. We've got like 4 months until Bleach is coming out. So around about that 3 month mark of when like Bleach is about to come out is when you'll start to see more advertising, more merchandise, more media in general in regards to like Twitter or Facebook or social media in general, as well as like Japanese TV. So I would definitely start seeing a lot more footage coming out as the coming weeks come forward. And I mean, the only reason why I also say that the Bleach anime is probably going to be showing more PVs towards around about the August time period is because I know the last time that I heard, especially as well, is that some episodes a bit further on, below 10 but above 5, are still within the corrections phase or the key design stage. So storyboarding was already done long ago, but I believe layouts was kind of done and now we're in the key animation stage. So, and corrections as well. So based off going off of that, I don't think they're ready to do some of the voice acting for later on in those stages before like 10 episodes. And I feel like for PVs, they usually show around about 1 to 5 episodes. They might even tease further than that. So I'm kind of basing it off of that at the moment. It really depends because not all the episodes are based off of Studio Pierrot. A lot of them have gone to outsourced studios as well. So again, take it with a pinch of salt, but that's kind of where my mentality about all this is at the moment. But again, once posted in this on like Thursday or Friday, for me it was insane the amount of attention that this screenshot had gotten from viewers and seeing how hyped people are and seeing how real this is, because it's cool being told things are happening, having a PV from like 6 months ago to having little to no news. I mean, you hear every now and then that there's no censorship, and you hear every now and then that Kubo's working on, you know, new sort of like movements for Unohana, for example, but to actually see for your eyes that this is a thing that is happening and it's physical and it's tangible is quite like a thing for people to kind of wrap their heads around. So again, enough of like the text updates, you're actually seeing in front of you something solid. And I think that's a people, from what I can tell anyway, has gotten people so excited that they have and have blown this up as much as they have as well. So again, tell me your guys' thoughts. When do you think the PV is happening? Do you think it's going to be happening in August, or do you think it's going to be happening in July? Again, Anime Expo in LA is around the corner as well, happening in July as well, at the very first week of July. So can Bleach get, you know, announced there by Crunchyroll? I honestly have been saying I truly hope so. I really do. But do I expect a PV around about that time? No, I don't think so. I think they'll replay the pre-animated trailer and say in an announcement. And possibly even a release date as well. I know it's in October, but to get a physical date would be cool as well. So that's kind of my speculation on things at the moment and where my thoughts and feelings are, because since this picture came out, everyone was like, oh, I should do a video and explain it to us. And yeah, that's where we are in production right now. Voice acting while post-production is happening, such as editing, compositing, effects, all that sort of stuff, like special effects and like glitter and all that you saw in the trailer. So, you know, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later anyway. Tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Of course, like and subscribe as per usual. And of course, thank you again for supporting the channel. Yeah, peace out.